I think the only easy part of RAAM was deciding to do it. You know, I've mentioned before to a few other people, and maybe even in one of my blogs, that I went into this kind of ignorant. I didn't spend a lot of time educating myself, which became very apparent when we got to West Virginia and I realized how hilly it actually was. But I really thought I had the mental capacity to do this. And after 25 plus years of riding bikes, I figured I had the physical ability to do it. And it was just whether I could put the two together. The guys who win this race and the guys who are in those top three or five, I mean, they're incredible athletes. And that really wasn't my goal. My goal was to finish, and that's something that I knew I had the ability to do, and I was just able to prove it.
Making it look easy.
Come on up here. Hi, Claudio.
Bye.
That's the first part. There's a lot here.
That's just the first part of her letter. And then she has a bunch of stars. She says, "You shine brighter than stars," with the abbreviation, whatever the acronym. And then she writes, she drew a picture of the U.S. She writes, "It's not about," I think she's, "a destination, it's about the ride." You have killer thighs. We'll see you when you get back, Abby. Smiley face. That's sweet. Look at that.
It's gonna make me cry, man. I promised I wouldn't cry.
So that's just water, cold water.
Hey.
If you need to use it on your head and stuff.
Watch out for the dog. Okay, but he's gonna mount it now.
Just like that.
Different mount, isn't it?
Uh-oh, don't drop it. John thinks it's a different mount.
Nope. Okay. What does John know? Him.
Was that a... Does that mean you're number one?
Nailed it.
I think that means you're number one.
We'll be right back.
The desert was hot. When we started this, I'd hoped to be a bit thinner. I was still a little heavy when we started, and I just chalked it up to that's what it is, and we just gotta go. If I was a little thinner, I might have been a bit cooler in the desert, but I don't know that you can possibly be cool when it's 116 degrees out. The good thing is I was still in a really great mindset in that point, having a tremendous crew that cared for me a ton, gave me all the water I needed both to drink and to pour on myself. We kept that nice, easy pace going, but we did keep moving, so we were constantly going forward. Seemed like we passed quite a few people at that point. You know, we were starting out from almost dead last and then moving our way up into as high as eighth place. It was good. It was just a testament to the plan that we had set up.
A spray tan, huh?
Absolutely.
Gotta keep it even.
One. Time this is done, I want to be a dot tan.
Oh, I don't know. It's pretty dark, bro. Saying things that you can't say tomorrow day. Crawling back to you. Never thought I'd call and run. You love you. Cause I always do. Maybe I'm too.
Says, dear Coach Matthew, you're as cool as my cat, and she's really cool. But anyway, thank you for making my Tuesdays and Wednesday memorable. Having somewhere to go and something to do is great. Stay strong. We'll be waiting for you in the finish line, spiritually, of course. Keep running. Keep running. Stay safe. See you Monday. Sincerely, Maria, aka Tiffany. And then P.S. Also, you should be a thigh model.
So danço samba, so danço samba. Vai, 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 vai. Só danço samba, só danço samba, vai. Só danço samba, só danço samba, vai, 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 vai. Só danço samba, só danço samba, vai. Já dancei o twist até demais, mas não sei, me cansei do calypso ao tchá-tchá-tchá. Só danço samba, só danço samba. Vai, 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 vai. Só danço samba, só danço samba. Vai.
So, with Equal Earth and Andrew Duggan as partners, it really gave us the ability, as Rob had mentioned, to do things properly. It was my first time. It was my rookie attempt at this, as they call it, and I'm not sure what the success rate of rookies are in finishing this, especially ones with as little experience as I had. But with Equal Earth's help and support, it allowed us to do a few things that I saw other teams not able to do. You know, all of my crew slept in hotels all the way across the country at night. They were as well rested as you could. I mean, nobody was happy at the end, but, well, I'm sorry, they were all happy at the end. They weren't all super rested, but they did get 5 to 6 hours of sleep every night, which kept them very alert and made the huge difference in me, both when I had my moments of falling apart, they were able to pick up the pieces, and when I was in a great mood, they were just falling along with that, because so were they. So Equal Earth really gave us the ability to do this properly and then to make all these dreams happen.
still have to summit this. It's about a mile up, and then a little dip, and then one more.
Oh, okay.
You're midway through the second one.
That's a good clarification.
I don't know, this might be the top.
This I'm is not the sure. top.
It is the top. John says
the next 3 miles or so.
When I got to Durango, I was feeling really good. You know, that section of the course I had done once before. I did that the previous year during RAW. And I took a lot of physical damage in doing that. I was a little ill-prepared. I had no real understanding of any kind of ultra riding. My bike positioning wasn't quite what I thought it would be good, and it turned out that it wasn't. So when we got to Durango this year, we did it in about the same amount of time as we did the previous year. However, I was feeling really good as opposed to just beat up and finished. So it was really positive when we got to Durango that I could go on, and knowing that about a third of it was behind us, feeling strong that I hadn't taken on any damage and I was still, you know, in positive both body and mind. The San Diego Velo Youth is an organization and a nonprofit that I started working with almost 3 years ago. It's an incredible organization. We take at-risk teens from some of the local schools, we bring them down to our velodrome, and we teach them values. We say they learn values one lap at a time, but the program is set up so that they can learn off the acronym STARS. It's self-respect, teamwork, achievement, responsibility. And then when you wrap all those together, it leads to success. When the kids graduate the program, where they've had positive participation, they've done our pay it forward, they've done our community service, they've done all the homework and everything required of them, they actually earn a bicycle, a lock, and a helmet. And for them, it's just a means of transportation. We're lucky. We get to ride our bikes and enjoy doing it, and that's our getaway. But for a lot of these kids, it's a way for them to get to jobs. It's a way for them to get to school. It's a way for them to get out of the places that they're at and discover new places so that they understand that changing their trajectory is possible. And that's really what we offer for them.
How many miles is it in the last 24 hours?
310 miles from Trinidad, Colorado to, what's the name of this town?
Somewhere in Kansas.
Greensboro.
310 miles.
I'll have to check with you.
Yeah.
Wow.
That's a lot.
Yeah. Definitely in
24 hours.
Yeah.
After doing, you know, after climbing across the Rockies, like it's really unfathomable to me.
Yeah.
And I've been a cyclist. Like I don't ride much anymore, but this is just so far beyond.
John?
Some peanut butter, some jelly, and some banana.
What kind of tortilla?
Whole wheat.
Yeah, whole wheat, all right.
Yeah, so this is, a lot of calories.
And that's what we need.
That's what we need. 2 tablespoons. This is about 1 tablespoon of peanut butter, yeah. So that's 95 calories plus 130 for 1 tortilla. So that's 225. Half a banana is another 50, so 275. Squirt of jelly. Another 50. 3 1/4. 325 calories.
Ain't no sleep when the wicked play. All we do is yell.
like sit down the side as well, okay? Yep.
What'd you say?
Thanks, I hate you all right now. That's what Matt's saying.
Where are you running to?
To the van.
You ran like a girl.
I am a girl.
Yeah, you look tough.
Yeah. 8 hours gone. We went to this place, pulled in behind the gas station. The employee walks out all the way across the parking lot to let us know the pool is nice. So I went to the pool, cleaned up.
Oh yeah. Round and round, round and round. I get around. Still clown when the underground. When we come around. Round and round, round and round. Stronger than ever. Back to get.
You guys get some rest?
Yeah. Cool. Yeah, I think that.
Oh. What'd you have?
I just had a spicy basil veggie. Jimmy had pad thai. They were out of fresh spring rolls and out of green thai and salad.
How does that even happen?
I know. I was like,
did they have Thai tea?
Thai food in the Philippines.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah. At least
and it took them like 20 minutes to make it.
Okay. Want me to take it for you? You said you wanted a picture?
Sure, yeah. I was just gonna grab a picture of him and put it on our Facebook page.
Oh, no, I'm taking it. I'll take it for you.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah.
1, 2, and 3. That's pretty damn good.
Cool, thanks.
Yeah, it must have just hit. I mean, I hit so many rocks, Tony.
Yeah, it's got a nick in it.
Okay. The other wheel, did you guys adjust the shifting?
Yeah,
right.
Okay, it is 10.
Yeah.
I never saw that. That's awesome.
And it's already moving. It's looking like it's
Sharon Dunlap said, "You are truly amazing." Mark Prince says, "Keep on trucking." This is all on one post, by the way. Jari Niskala, the man, state by state, getting closer. Jennifer Janice says, "Way to go, Matt." Bob White says, "Down the backside, nice." I'm not sure what that exactly means, down the backside, but I'd rather.
That's why we call him Boo.
He must have spoke Bob to Raw. No, Paul Healing says, "Go, Matt, go."
Hard time.
Nice job. nice job of letting us all enjoy your path of suffering. Envy and admiration for all that you are doing.
Envy?
That's what he says, envy.
I'm sorry, I checked that.
Dennis Cruzan, Cruzan, go get him, Matt, we're pulling for you. Giuseppe Cufa? Chufa? C-I-U-F-F-A? Proud of you, brother. Stay strong. You look good.
You know, when we crossed the Mississippi, it was kind of sad because it was at night and I didn't even see it. I didn't even realize we had gone across it yet. And quite honestly, I might have been a little tired at that moment. So it was pretty amazing. When I realized that we'd hit the 2,000 mile mark, I honestly was elated that we'd gotten that far, and also a bit nervous that there's still a third left to go. I realized that last third was maybe just as hard as the first two thirds. And we just took it little by little. You know, it's our starfish story that we tell, and how we just, you know, one at a time, you just have to go mile by mile. And with some real wisdom from the crew, I decided to take the computer off my bike, take everything off my bike, and just ride. And it made a lot of sense. It cleared my mind. It kept me focused on the important things, which was pedaling, eating, and the little bit of sleep we got. Dave Preston, in many ways, got me started in this. In 2013, I actually crewed for him, kind of wanting to understand what RAAM was all about, knowing that it was a bike ride across the country, but not knowing the real bare-bone details of it. And when I crewed for him, I learned in a hard way how tough this could be. And when I saw him finish the race, it was truly amazing to see an athlete go through what he went through and then still succeed. So that got me spurred on or interested in doing a longer race. And I'd had on plan to do a 400 mile race. And I did not do that. Again, with Dave's help, he talked me into doing Raw, which was 880 miles. So I just jumped straight over the top of that. And to this day, and probably forever, Raw and RAAM are the two ultra races I've done, and probably the only ones that I have done.
What's going to keep you going the next 750 miles?
The bike.
Okay.
No, I'm just joking.
It's got to be more fun than that.
Still good. Waka waka.
We started as kind of a desire to get it done, and we're getting closer and closer. You know, these guys are great, and I have full support. It's fun. We find the fun in the kind of messed up stuff, you know. There's a few times where it's really messed up.
Are you caught up in the competition? Are you catching these guys?
I'm not. You know, I try not to be.
Yeah.
You know, it's hard not to, but I also know that could actually end my bid.
Right.
You know, I rode a little harder than I should have to get here. I had my distances off. You know, I woke up this morning, I rode, and I thought it was 160. It was 160 to here, and it was like 178 to here, and that was way different.
Which is nothing when you're training at home.
Right. That's a huge difference in effort output measures. So. When I got here, it was a little cool where I should have been. So you took a nap.
I did.
No, I'm good. No,
feel fresh.
I'm gonna ride. You know, I'll take another nap, and it'll be till after about 125 or 130 miles again.
Okay. That'll put you in your Ohio.
Yep.
There was two real good times for me during the whole course of this event that I just didn't know if I was going to make it to the finish. One of them was in Illinois, I think, and I'd lost it a bit. I had moved up into eighth place, and I thought it was time for me to really show how tough I am and start racing. And after about 3 days of that, I'd realized that it was beyond my capability at the moment, and luckily I was able to pull it all back together, but it certainly wasn't without help from friends. I remember sitting on the side of the road, pretty emotional, and one of my friends, Dave Preston, came up to me and he goes, "Well, you knew this was going to be hard, right?" And with a tearful voice, I replied, "I didn't." So I ended up getting into those hard sections, and luckily with those guys' support, I made it through that. We also had a lot of social media presence, which was kind of unusual. In the last 4 years, I'd valued myself based on some mistakes that I had made. And unfortunately, even though those were small mistakes in the big picture of life, they weighed very heavy on me. And one thing I learned in this trip is how many people I've affected in positive ways, and how many people were out there supporting me and encouraging me. And it's just been overwhelming. I mean, my heart is just full from all the people who've taken the time to follow us, or even taken the time to post something that said how I'd affected them. And quite honestly, I was very blind to it. It's how I've lived my life, but I never saw it. So somewhere along the way from Oceanside to Annapolis, I actually found a great deal of value in me as a person. And I know that there's so much more that's still to come, even now after finishing this race, that I'm going to learn about myself. So, you know, with everybody's help, this is probably one of the most positive experiences I've ever had in my entire life.
We're gonna take you to the next time station. That's when you get to go down, okay? We got caffeine, energy in you. Keep the calories coming.
How many miles after this one is that one?
58.
So another
58. Relatively flat. All right, this is the shitty time station you just did. All shit climbs. All right, we're almost done with that shit. Here's the next one. Flat, that's only 50 feet. It's pretty flat and then it's downhill and it's gonna be a lot faster, okay? We'll get through that and then we'll go down. Hang in there, Matt.
The rain affected me in a few different ways. One is, I'd like to believe I'm a good bike handler and a good bike rider, and it was really limiting the amount of speed that I felt I could go downhill, especially tired and especially at night. And of course, that's where one of my crashes, or the bigger crash, came from. You know, it was just, your body is already uncomfortable. Your mind's already, you know, a little not straight and on its last threads, and you're trying to hold everything together, and then you're just stomped with rain on top of it, and it just added more to that difficulty. Now, sitting here talking to you, I think it's great because it was just more adversity that I was able to overcome. At the time, I certainly wasn't looking at it in any positive way at all. And again, it was just, the whole race is just overcoming what's getting put towards you, just like life. And you know, one of the big lessons that I've learned is how truly strong and how durable I can be when I need to be. And I'm gonna take that and I'm gonna keep using it for the rest of my life and help make Velo Youth more successful with the determination I learned that I have from that race. As we got closer and closer to the finish, it was funny. It was almost like every pedal stroke I took, there was somebody on the other side pulling the finish further away from me. It was pretty amazing. It just did not seem to get closer. Those last 100 miles, those last 50 miles, even those last 20 miles were just harder and harder and harder. You know, you feel like you're almost there, but you still can't touch it, you know? And it's a very difficult feeling. My body was getting more and more uncomfortable. I just wanted to be done, and the sad part was that I didn't have the ability to just speed up and get there. Like it was, I don't want to say it was out of my control, but it was out of my ability to do so. So with everybody's help, the one thing that I realized I had the ability to do was just to keep moving, and I just kept moving forward. The whole journey started out with the help of Andrew Duggan and Equal Earth. I've only known him for a few years. We have an incredible relationship that developed very quickly with a mutual respect for each other, especially being that we come from such diverse backgrounds. And just his faith alone in me to be able to accomplish something like this, something that I wasn't even sure that I could do, and he was that confident that I could do it. It's amazing. Then we partner up with Rob Panzera and CCSD and every one of the other crew members who came along and gave their time and not just gave it, but really did the very best that they could. I've never felt so cared for in my life. It's only now that I realized how hard it was for those guys to care as much about me as they do, and then to push me to the point where I was really uncomfortable and they had to keep moving me forward and getting me to move forward. And I always believed that they were just doing what I asked them to do, but then I realized how difficult it was on them. So there are no words to thank everybody who came along with me, to thank all the people who supported me the whole way across the country. And I just want everybody to know is without all of that support and with all of that care, there is no possible way I could have made it.